officially the new year, and I wanted to revisit one of my favorite effects on the channel, which is this textured filled burning effect. It's a prime example of quick, fun, and effective, and mildly grotesque, which is my preferred combo. But if you don't know me, I'm Abby Sparza, and I don't come just bearing tutorials, but other gifts as well. Photomanipulation.com is having a huge New Year's Eve sale. Not only are things 40% off when using the code NEWYEAR40, but when you buy something, you'll be sent a coupon to get another item of your choosing completely free. Let's start 2024 on the right foot. The sale is running from Tuesday, yes, today Tuesday, till Saturday, and you can find all the information down in the description. And the PM team hopes you have a great year. I already have my subject all prepped and ready to go, as well as a color grade. However, I can provide a learning PSD to this one. I'm always trying to figure out how to do that because I do use some stock images from sites like Pexels. So what I've done is linked the Pexels resources below, and you can just drag and drop them right into the PSD and update the smart objects. Easy peasy. I made a mini brush set as well, so you can follow right along with me. But we have to get going, so we're going to create two adjustment layers, starting right off. The first being a black to white gradient map, and the second being a brightness contrast layer, bringing the brightness down to around 27 and the contrast up to about 44. That's of course subject dependent. We're going to double click on the layer to open up the layer style panel and adjust the blend if settings as well. We're going to slide around these toggles, holding Alt to split the toggles up. And we want to take the darker color out of the highlights of the face. So we're telling Photoshop to blend this image away from the lighter values of the image below it. In this case, the face. Looking good. Next, let's group these two layers and add a layer mask to that group. And we're going to invert the mask from white to black by hitting Ctrl or Command I, which will hide those adjustments for now. And let's hold Ctrl or Command and click the subject layer to grab a selection in the shape of her. And next, using any kind of grunge brush set to white, start masking back in that adjustment layer group. This is going to be the foundation or base of our burning skin, so you're going to want to mask in any area you intend to have all charred up. The brush isn't really important, use any brush that gives you some nice jagged edges, but I did include this one in a download link in the description. Once happy, you can go ahead and close the group up, naming it adjustments to keep things somewhat tidy. And with our base all set, we're going to add some texture to this darkened gray skin. It's not very charcoaly right now. Let's create a new group, copy, drag, and drop the layer mask from the adjustments group right onto it. And we're going to name this new group texture. Textures of rocks, tree bark work great for creating a charred surface effect. We are going to drop this one in the group, and I'll link it down in the description. This one is from Pexels. And let's set our texture to overlay and convert it to a right-click smart object if it isn't already. You'll also want to bring the saturation of the texture all the way down, turning it grayscale. I use hue saturation for this. It really doesn't matter what you use. And finally, you'll want to darken the texture and most likely increase the texture's contrast. And this will change from image to image, but this is kind of the vibe we want. Since it's a smart object, we can also change this later, which you very well might have to. But now we can move the texture around and place it properly, looking for a spot that might create some cool shapes or effects. In my first image of this, I used a rock texture, but it's no longer available, but you can see how different textures can create different vibes and shape in the skin. I actually really like how this flaky tree bark turned out. I'd suggest trying out a few options, in fact. But once we're happy with the placement of things, we can duplicate our texture, and we're going to increase the brightness of the brightness contrast smart filter here. And up that opacity to roughly 40%. Let's add a mask, inverting with Ctrl or Command I again. And this is masking in our subject's highlights. A soft round brush will work perfectly fine here. These highlights will be fairly subtle. We will be punching them up a whole lot more in just a moment, so let's just focus on the brightest areas, like maybe the forehead or the nose. Just anywhere we want to bring in a little bit more depth into the textures, because this will make it look like the charred skin is really lifting up. And to finish this up, and this is optional, but you can add a drop shadow layer effect to the whole texture group to create a bit of a dirtier or almost soot-like edge. Basically, it'll darken the edges in general. Just a little detail, but worth doing. Why not? We're going to finish up our charred skin by adding the subject adjustments and texture groups into yet another group, naming this whole group Burn, and then adding a layer mask. So with this mask, you can make any global adjustments to your burned skin, the mask that is, mostly refining the mask with your grungy brush. I do tend to fiddle around with things for absolute ages. It's really very dull to watch, so I'm just going to do this quick and dirty like. This is just so you can refine the shape without updating each mask individually. In fact, this looks perfectly fine to me. But you may have noticed we have lost most of our subject's features. The eyes and the nose are gone. You're going to want to bring them back using a mixture of overlay and normal layers. So let's go ahead and create two layers, placing them both above the burn group here. And go ahead and paint in tiny little highlights and reflections on a normal layer using a default round brush, both soft and hard. These are called like specular highlights, just little bright spots that show the skin is shiny and not matte. Then we can use the second layer set to overlay to bring out the highlights even more, again painting with white. We're really just focusing on the eyes and lips, making sure they stand out amongst all those dark shadows. A quick tip, you can always adjust the blend if settings on a layer to really pinpoint those highlights, using the left toggles to take the light out of the shadows. That'll make them look really, really sharp. That's just how I get those very precise highlights on my textures and surfaces, including just normal skin. On that normal layer, we're just painting in eyelashes and little specular highlights, like I said, on the lips and eyes and stuff. But once we're happy, let's group those layers and name it makeup or something. Definition, maybe. Moving on, we're going to group the makeup group, the burn group, and the subject all into one final master subject group. So all of our groups are in this master subject. We're going to add a layer mask to the master group and mask in some texture to the edges of our subject's face. Things like chips and cracks, just texture. This burned skin clearly has a lot of it, so we just want the edges of that subject to reflect that. And we can do it real quick for the sake of the tutorial. This is looking good. Let's close up our group because we are moving on to the final highlights. First, create and clip a curves layer into the master group, and we're going to jack up those highlights. Adjust the blend if settings, bringing the light out of the shadows, so we're really just targeting the highlights that already exist. And then we're going to invert the layer mask, turning it to black, and start painting in our highlights. Hitting the high points of the subject, like again the forehead, though that's a little bright right now. Let's say the nose and cheeks for sure. Also the edges of the rocky texture. And if we need even higher highlights, we can always duplicate that curves layer, reset the layer mask back to black, and push them even further. With that being said, don't worry too much about this part. You aren't going to know exactly how bright you need your highlights to be until you place your flames in fire. This is kind of my third or fourth time running through this image, so I already kind of have an idea, but these things aren't in a 1-2-3 format. You're going to go back and forth. You're going to adjust things as you go. If you need to go back and adjust your initial texture adjustments or painting in some more highlights, painting in some more texture, then just do it. But once you're happy, that is going to be our charred skin done, and we can finally start adding in some embers coming from within the cracks of the skin. This is my favorite part. Go ahead and create a new layer, setting it to screen. And right off the bat, let's add an outer glow layer effect, As always, play with and adjust these settings to fit your exact image. However, this is a good starting point. You can find these exact settings to copy and paste in the PSD linked in the description, so I won't just list them all off. I know these had issues in the original tutorial, so now you can just copy and paste them right into your own PSD. We're also going to pair this outer glow with an inner shadow, and that'll give the embers some color variation, and that's what these settings are here. With that, we're going to use a neon yellow-orange color to paint in our glowing inner ember bits. For the brush, if you have a kind of scratchy brush like this, then that'll work wonderfully. I'll provide some options down below for you to download for free, of course. This brush and any brush is going to look a little sharp, more likely than not, but don't worry about that for now. Before we worry about all that and like refining the brush, we're going to use this brush to paint lines of ember showing through the cracks of the subject's burnt skin, or what have you. You can do this on objects as well. I'm using a tablet here, and I won't lie, being able to play with different taper and opacity pressure settings really does help here. However, to recreate a very similar effect, very similar taper effect, you can use the eraser tool set to a soft round brush, and then erase the edges of the line so they start looking kind of tapered. Make the lines very jittery, with some parts being thicker and brighter than others, some being kind of dark, some long, some short, and some just little small dots, like the light is just barely peeking through. Follow the cracks, giving everything a nice flow and making sure they kind of have a logic to them, as well as kind of shape the face in a nice way. Whether you're using a tablet or not, you can experiment with the brush settings, turning up the scattering and the spacing. That's always a great habit to get into. You don't have to use a brush as is, play with those settings. And don't feel locked into one shade of orange either. You can choose a lighter and a darker shade, and then switch between the two using X. And that'll keep your embers nice and varied. Like I said, this really is the funnest part in my opinion, but we have one more step to make our embers really meld into the skin, so let's finish this up. And we want to take the smudge tool and set it to around 40% strength. And now we want to blur and drag certain parts of our embers. This will do one of three things, or all three things. It'll help the ember light taper really nicely and wrap around the shapes of the face and burnt skin. Two, it'll help the embers match the sharpness of the image. The brush on its own is a little too sharp, like I said before, so this will soften them up and really match the soft focus of the original image. And three, it'll give some movement to the embers, making them look like they are lifting up and floating away, as hot embers tend to do. We don't want to add any kind of global blur, just spot tree and really look at the embers and how they are interacting with the skin. And once we're happy with our embers, it's all smooth sailing from here, because we're going to use the oldest Photoshop trick in the book, adding fire to an image using the screen layer mode. But I do have a few tricks for you. But let's get our fire and set it to screen. If you need to, lower the shadows of the image using a curves adjustment. This will make sure there's no background left over. It'll really knock out those blacks. Oh, we aren't going to stop there though. We're going to use the transform warp mode to shape our flame, just to make it more in line with the overall composition. Here I really like the idea of the fire also looking like horns, so it can be little stuff like that. This is looking perfectly fine. Next, let's mold our fire around the model's features, like this ear here, using the smudge tool set to a strength of around 80%. You might need to experiment a bit with that number, but basically this will allow you to drag the edges of the flame, letting it warp and envelop an object, much like fire would in reality. This makes it seem much less flat and stock photo-y. This is a great little touch and a personal favorite of mine. Don't skip this one. But don't hate me, I'm going to just snap the rest of my fire right in here. Because my next tip is to make fire less floaty and see-through-y by creating a layer right below a flame, keeping it set to normal, and then painting with either a dark red, burnt orange, or maybe a bright yellow, possibly all three, all depending on the area and circumstance here. We are basically painting a solid color behind the flame to make the flame more opaque, less transparent. In this image, I didn't need to do it all that much because it's already a darker image, so there's not much to see behind that flame. But if you ever find your fire is looking very Photoshoppy, very transparent, then give this a try. And then we're going to finish up with a couple layers set to screen above all the flame layers, using them to paint a nice glowy orange around your flames and fire. And that is all there is to creating a burning effect in Photoshop. Take two. It's really just two adjustment layers and a texture doing most, if not all, of the heavy lifting, if you really think about it. That being said, the devil is in the details, so don't skip on those details. Take your time and just paint your nice little embers. With that, like if you like, subscribe if you really like, and if you want to be my friend, follow me on social media or join my Discord. We have all kinds of fun, all linked down below. And don't forget about our big New Year's sale, all down in the description as well. See you guys real soon.